has really described, it's mostly a huge police crime scene at this point, with lots and lots and lots of law enforcement from, you know, surrounding jurisdictions. You know, the bottom line is this event is over, obviously in a very tragic way, with three people being shot dead inside the mall. We have talked to people who were inside the mall at the time that this happened, sometime between 11 and 11:30 this morning. It was in the food court area of the Columbia Mall, which is near the Sears department store, which is attached to the mall. And what witnesses describe is they were shopping. It's a very busy mall on any day, especially on a Saturday. They hear gunshots. And those who were not right at the scene describe being taken to the back of the stores in which they were shopping. So clearly, we've heard that from a number of people who were inside at the time. So clearly, mall personnel had trained for this kind of an event, mm-hmm. because no matter which store they were in, we talked to a couple of different people in different stores, that's what they were told. We have heard from other witnesses who could see in the area of the shooting kind of a little more of what was going on. And, of course, police have confirmed that there are three dead, including the gunman.
Okay.
We are awaiting really a press conference by the Howard County Police Department. It's supposed to happen at any moment now. As Roy described, there are people that are leaving the mall. All of the entrances to the mall around the Columbia Mall are sealed off by state police while they continue to try to sort all of this out. As I mentioned, this is a crime scene, so... or presumably so that's one of the things that they're trying to do also is to preserve that area where this happened.
Jayne, I'm sure this question is a little too early, but I'm going to ask you anyway. What do we know yet about the relationship between the shooter and the victims?
We don't. We don't know anything at this point. I mean, just to be clear, this was not a situation of, you know, the shots are fired and police get here and there's an exchange of gunfire with police. As far as we know, when police got here, the three people were dead. Mm-hmm. So this was already an inactive scene by the time the police arrived. So we don't know if this was an altercation between people who knew each other. We don't know if this was someone who, for whatever reason, pulled out a gun and started shooting and then shot himself. We hope to learn more about that in this briefing that is going to take place. You know, if you had to ask me, I don't know, but
yeah.
Based on my experience, it sounds more like a situation where people may have known each other.
I was getting that sense as well. Jayne, what are we...
You know,
go ahead.
Food court areas are also places where, you know, folks hang out. And, mm-hmm. you know, on a Saturday morning, it's probably a pretty busy place. So, you know, we'll see. We'll see what information do we get when this briefing starts.
And of the reports, Jayne, about the shooter being found next to gun and ammunition. Any more specifics on that?
Not at all, except that you know, that's how they were able to identify that the shooter was among the dead. Our producer Shannon Encina has been here since the start, and she just talked to one of the witnesses that was in the mall at the time. Actually, Shannon, get me the other side of the car here because I'm on Bluetooth. And she'll be able to talk then, and you'll
good.
Be able to hear what she says. How's that sound?
Okay, that sounds good. Shannon?
Okay, Shannon, start talking then. Tell us what that young woman just told us.
I talked to Lauren Stapleton, who works at one of the nearby stores that has a lot of kids in there, and then she said she saw, heard a couple gunshots and then saw three people fall. Then they eventually... got the kids inside. Hurdle, she said it was complete chaos. But they huddled the kids in as long as they could. She said they're obviously scared, but everyone kept talking to remain calm. She said eventually a SWAT person came in through GNC, if I remember correctly, and then was saying, okay, everyone put your hands up and get out, get out.
Shannon, did she give you any indication? Did Lauren have any idea whether these people were in an argument? Did they know each other? Did she know of anything that happened beforehand?
No, and I asked her that specifically. She said she didn't know what prompted all of this. She just heard the gunshots, saw people go down, and then people started running everywhere. She said she tried to call 911 a couple times. It was obviously jammed up. But she said she started seeing everyone kind of run into stores. Yes, go ahead.
No, I'm curious just about, and Jayne, you might be able to answer this as well. I haven't heard any witnesses describe seeing the gunman walking through the mall. In other words, it leads me to believe that is there an entrance to the food court area? In other words, could the shooter have just gone into that food court area
into that area? Yeah, I believe so. I think you can walk pretty directly into that area. That is correct.
Okay.
I mean, this is either someone who walked in with a gun visible or had a gun on him or her and started firing. I mean, those are some of the details. There are lots and lots and lots of questions here about what's happened. Obviously, this follows, you know, other incidents around the country. It involves very public places, and so, you know, we have a lot to sort out here.
Sure, sure. Okay, so we're expecting a briefing any moment, correct?
That's correct, and we'll certainly keep you updated.
All right, Jayne, thank you. We want to go back. Jayne and Shannon Encina, our producer, thank you both.